The Honourable Minister for Sustainable Development.
Thank you very much, Madam Speaker. November 25th is the International Day for the Elimination of Violence Against Women. It also marks the beginning of 16 days of activism against gender-based violence. Madam Speaker, we know that women and girls here in Manitoba and around the world are all too often subjected to sexual violence, abuse, and harassment. Unfortunately, we know that some women and girls around the world are also subjected to sexual violence as a horrific act of war. One such community is the Yazidis. In the summer of 2014, ISIS swept into the Sinjar region of northern Iraq, systemically targeting the Yazidi people. Those who were unable to flee were rounded up in what the UN, and indeed this legislature, has recognized as a genocide. Men who refused demands to convert to Islam were shot, while the women were taken into captivity. There they experienced horrible abuse, being passed from captor to captor and used as sexual slavery. Last week, the Yazidi Association of Manitoba reached out to me to discuss their members' experience of the use of sexual violence in conflict. I was honoured to be able to meet with them this afternoon, along with my colleagues from Rossmere, St. Norbert, and Fort Richmond. All of us, Madam Speaker, have an obligation to stand up against the use of sexual violence as a weapon of war. And while we are fortunate enough to live in a country that is not experiencing anything remotely resembling that level of violence or genocide, we all need to work together to eradicate gender-based violence here at home in Manitoba and around the globe. I welcome members of our wonderful Yazidi community here at the Legislature today. I thank them for sharing with me their story of survival and their courage and hope. And I want all of them to know that here in Manitoba, we are your allies in eradicating gender-based violence. I invite all Manitobans to join the 16 Days of Activism and use the hashtag #HearMeToo as together we work towards ending gender-based violence. Thank you, Madam Speaker, and thank you to the Yazidi community who is here with us today.